Today, we shall start with the next chapter of physical chemistry, that is known as ionic equilibrium. In this chapter, we shall be studying in detail the following points: Arrhenius theory of ionization, concepts of acids and bases, hydrolysis of salts, Ostwald dilution law, common ion effect, pH and its calculations, buffer solutions, solubility and solubility product, KSP, and finally, indicators for acid-base titrations. So, let us now begin with Arrhenius theory of ionization, whose main postulates are: the first, when substances like acids, bases and salts are dissolved into water, they split up into two types of charge particles. Particles carrying positive charge are called cations, and those carrying negative charge are called anions. For example, when sodium chloride solid is dissolved into water, it splits up into Na plus and Cl minus ions. Second point, the solution of an electrolyte is electrically neutral because the total positive charge in the solution is equal to total negative charge. Third point, since process of ionization is a reversible one, therefore a state of equilibrium is bound to be achieved, and that is called ionic equilibrium. And hence, law of mass action can be applied over it, as we had earlier applied to chemical equilibrium. Consider the dissociation of acetic acid into water. CH3COOH aqueous reversibly dissociates into CH3COO- and H+. Therefore, according to law of mass action, equilibrium constant K is equal to CH3COO- into H+ upon CH3COOH. This equilibrium constant with respect to acid is called dissociation constant of the acid, and therefore written as Ka. Similarly, for a base, equilibrium constant will be written as Kb. The fourth point, whole of the electrolyte does not undergo complete ionization. Therefore, the extent of ionization is called degree of ionization or degree of dissociation alpha. Alpha is equal to number of molecules ionized divided by total number of molecules of the electrolyte in the solution. Remember, the value of alpha is almost equal to unity for strong electrolytes. Strong electrolytes are those substances which are considered to be almost completely ionized under all conditions. They are strong acids, strong bases, and almost all types of salts, as we shall see their examples later.